I'm letting TikTok take over this week. Here are some of my favorite Cricut vinyl hacks.
Cricut hack. Grab all of the different colors of vinyl that you have. You will also need cardstock, a binder, and 9 pocket binder sheets. Open Cricut Design Space and click Shapes and Square. Unlock the padlock and type in the dimensions of your cardstock sheet. Measure the pockets on your binder sheet and open Shapes and Square on Cricut Design Space again. Once you have the dimensions of one pocket, copy and paste the rectangle to make 9 in total. Spread them out on the sheet. Delete the cardstock template on Design Space, and send to your Cricut. These rectangular sheets will act as a surface for your vinyl. Once you have all of your rectangles cut out, click Shapes and Square to make a square that perfectly fits over your rectangle. Cut out a square from each color of vinyl that you have. Peel off the vinyl from its backing paper and apply it to the rectangle. Write the name of the color in the space above. Once you are done, you will be able to keep track of your vinyl colors a lot better.
Saw this vinyl hack on TikTok. I am all about space savers because my workspace is small. Yeah, this voice is beep. All this stuff came from the Dollar Tree. Put them together like this. Cut, cut, cut. Ta-da, I love this. I can add to more later.
Favorite Cricut hacks. If you have vinyl sheets, use a milk crate and hanging file folders to store them. So easy to find colors and stay organized. Once you're done weeding, keep your HTV on sheet protectors in a binder. I love doing this when I'm prepping a lot of projects at once. It peels off so easily.
Do you ever have vinyl scraps and you have no idea what to do with it? Well, I have the perfect solution for you. This is the one I use. You don't have to use the same as me. I use the heart shape. There's stars, there's circles, there's different shapes you can use. Always make sure that you're putting the vinyl backwards. If you put the vinyl facing the punch, it is going to get stuck. I use Oracle 651 as my vinyl. Any hard vinyl that's thicker is the best solution. You can also use different sizes. I found this little one on Amazon. I love that it's like you can like punch it with your hand. It's so cool and it's so much easier than the other punch. As you can see, don't use it on Cricut vinyl. It's just gonna damage your punch. You can use these in packaging. You can use these as freebies. You can even put it on cups. Duet me if you use this hack.
Hello, Cricut vinyl hack for you on this Wednesday. Do you ever have a hard time deciding which one is HTV, which one's permanent, and which one's removable? Maybe they're all in a bin and you have no idea which one's which. I can help. So permanent vinyl, this is Cricut permanent vinyl. Not only does it say permanent, but it also has green lines. Removable vinyl has gray lines on the back. Then you have HTV vinyl, which usually doesn't have any lines or anything on the back. Follow me for more tips and tricks.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Let's go!
Level up, 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 level up.
Time for a Cricut hack. Do you ever have trouble putting your vinyl on your mat? Put your mat under your Cricut machine and then just reveal a little bit at a time. This means that you can line up your vinyl easily with the top and then just move your mat out to stick the vinyl to the rest of the mat. Hope this helps. Like, comment, and follow for more.
When you cut your vinyl like this, it's actually cutting at an angle and not giving the perfect cut. Grab one of your rolls of vinyl, grab the brown tube inside, take it, and put it underneath your mat. From there, you'll make your project like normal. This is a level surface so that when it cuts perfectly. Make sure you follow and like for all your Cricut tips and tricks.
Stop cutting and wasting your vinyl. Here's what you need.
grab your mat, grab your roll, and grab some bobby pins. Place down your vinyl and bobby pin it to your mat. After your vinyl is done cutting, what you're going to do is just cut out the space that you used and save the rest.
This is how you cut out multiple colors of vinyl, only doing one cut. Mix the layers, click on color sync, and you're going to drag and drop each object onto one color. This will tell the mat it's only going to make one color. Click make it. Then you're going to map it, allowing extra space around the cut just in case. While comparing my design on Cricut Design Space on the computer, I'll lay everything out on the mat. Next, load your mat and click make it. When pulling your design off the mat, always pull your mat off the design versus pulling your design off the mat. This prevents any kind of crinkles and creases into your designs. Follow me for more help on your Cricut. You can also find me on Facebook now. Hope this helps.
Here's a hack for everyone that has told me that I wasted a lot of vinyl while cutting. You'll see here I have some butterflies and flowers that I need to be placed. So I'm cutting out the tech wrap that I am using and I am placing it onto the mat, the same place the design space is telling me it's going to cut it. Once I have that done, I will just weed it out after it's been cut, and you'll see here I'm not wasting a lot of vinyl and it works out in the end. Then I just place it onto the cup. So I hope this helps everyone.
Dollar Tree Cricut Hack. Can you not see all your lines when you're weeding? Here's what you need to do. Take some cornstarch or some baby powder and put it on top of your vinyl. You'll take a makeup brush and brush it in. This makes weeding a lot easier and you'll be able to see exactly what you're doing. Once you finish weeding, all that baby powder will just be wiped away and then you're done.
Okay, here's another vinyl hack that has saved me so much time. If you have all these tiny little pieces that you need to get out of something, just put a piece of tape over it. Masking tape or painter's tape works better, but this is all I had. Literally just lift up and look at that. Oh my gosh.
Okay, we're gonna make weeding a little bit easier. We're gonna take some painter's tape, you're gonna wrap it around your hand, and then you're gonna just start weeding like you normally would, and instead of putting the vinyl somewhere else, you're gonna put it on top of that tape. This makes the weeding process super easy. You're just placing the vinyl on top of the tape, sticky on sticky surface, just makes your life a little bit easier. Hopefully this helps. Follow and like for more tips and tricks.
So my mom bought me this vinyl, but it wasn't sticking to the transfer tape, but I remembered a hack I saw on TikTok. That painter's tape works really good. So minimal scraping, it came off great and it applied even better. I will definitely be using this in the future.
Trick to get your layered vinyl design to match up perfectly. I'm going to take my first layer and put a piece of parchment paper between the layer and the bottom layer. And this way I can see through it and move the parchment paper around until I get the decal exactly where I want it. Then simply scrape it onto your layer and do the same thing for the top layer. Again, I'm going to use the parchment paper as a guide. You can move it around easily without it sticking to the layer before you're ready. Once it's lined up, you take the parchment paper out and you have a perfectly layered.
Vinyl bubbles. Try the wet applic.
Silencio Bruno!
Silencio Bruno!
Silencio Bruno!
Silencio Bruno!
Can you still hear him?
Nope, just you!
Good! Now hang on!